What I remember was a huge white cloud enveloping us, but very gently. It wasn't in any way violent. It was very gentle. It enveloped us, and we were standing, and the next moment we were flat on our faces on the ground with a floor above that had come down to 30 centimeters above our floor. So there was about this much space between the two. And we were flat with our arms out to the sides, but we couldn't move.
It shook and shook and shook, and some people were praying, some people were screaming, and I think I was just saying, stop it, stop it, something like this.
On appelait Jésus, Jésus, sauve-nous, et on ne pouvait pas savoir ce qu'on pouvait faire. Et à un certain moment, et les secousses, les répliques augmentaient, et on était paniqués, et on croyait vraiment que tout était fini. On avait vu la mort ce jour-là.
The whole floor shifted. The tiles, they're about just under 1 square meter. That's the best way I can explain it. The whole tile moved, a tile to the right and back again, and then to the left and back again.
Là où j'étais au troisième étage. Je suis, lorsque c'est écrasé, j'étais jusqu'au sol. C'est pour cela que j'ai eu la chance peut-être. Et j'ai entendu quelqu'un qui disait, voilà, il y a un trou quelque part. Ceux qui sont vivants, débrouillez-vous pour sortir.
Tout le monde criait, mon Dieu, mon Dieu, mon Dieu. Et puis, je suis sortie de ma cachette. Et puis, j'ai vu des gens couverts de sang.
It was difficult to breathe. You couldn't see a hand in front of you. It was just like thick, thick fog.
There was another shock. A very strong aftershock. And at that moment, really, we looked at each other thinking that was our turn. So we saw really death, I think, in that moment.
I heard like one voice composed by thousands of voices. So there were thousands of people screaming at the same time. It was horrible. And so I understood it was an earthquake. It wasn't just, you know, our building that collapsed for, you know, some strange reason. It was an earthquake. And that time I realized that the Christopher, the HQ, wasn't there anymore.
Don't we have rope? We need rope.
There was no doubt in my mind. It was impossible to survive the collapsing of the HQ. And I knew who was on duty, from the police commissioner's office and going all the way up to fourth floor, I was certain. And I knew that political affairs were on fifth and sixth floor.
Initially, all I was doing is standing there and giving direction, telling people what needed to be done, talk to them, and everybody was digging with their hands because we didn't have any tool. There was no tool at all. And I remember there was two Philippine girls that were somewhere, and the group that I sat there said they could hear them. And I'm like, you go ahead and talk to them in your language. That would calm them down.
We'll get you from there. Just take it easy. We'll be here for you guys.
The rest of the people, was one gentleman that we can see him, we saw his arm, and I promised him that we're never going to leave until we'll get him out. But the problem, he was stuck in between the elevator.
C'était la soirée la plus longue de notre vie parce qu'on avait d'autres personnes qui étaient dehors. J'avais ma petite soeur qui était partie pour l'université. J'avais mon cousin qui était parti pour son cabinet d'avocat et qui n'est jamais revenu. on se disait, Seigneur, fais qu'ils soient en vie juste pour les voir demain matin. Et la nuit n'en finissait pas.
Puisque tout le monde autour de moi pleurait et on voyait des maisons s'écouler, les premières idées qui m'est venue en tête, c'est que ma famille, toute ma famille, était morte.
Il y a des amis qui sont morts autour de moi, je ne peux pas me mouvoir. Il y a ceux qui ne sont pas morts, je les entends crier, mais j'ai passé deux jours, mais à chaque heure, c'est comme si ça taisait, on n'entend plus les voix, on n'entend personne. Bon, j'étais désespérée avant parce que je pensais que j'allais mourir là-bas.
They had open wounds on her head. People were carrying kids, which were limp. You didn't know whether they were alive. You had injuries. People were walking on the bone of their foot, with their foot completely on a different angle than it was supposed to be.
Un morceau du béton qui était collé là à ma tête, et à chaque secousse, ça entrait, ça me pesait. Ça faisait vraiment mal, j'avais eu beaucoup de maux de tête.
How long ago did you last hear that?
Last time I heard someone was 36 to 48 hours ago.
36 to 48 hours ago was the last time you heard. What was it? Was it tapping? Was it a voice?
It was tapping. It was tapping.
In relation to where you were, do you know what direction?
That way.
To the... Okay.
I just crossed the gate and I saw that the house was down and didn't want to see more than that. And then a few days after that, I went back again to check if I could rescue something. And I think it was so shocking, because it was the same day that the rescue people, well, rescue, no, they took out bodies of people who died in my apartment.
Here.
Come on.
One, two, three. I'm not going, you know, somewhere where there is a war to be, that kind of photographer. But that day was the only thing I could do. I had nightmares. I didn't sleep well for a long time. But during those days, I wasn't thinking. I wasn't able to think. I was just waking up, going out, shoot, sending and editing photos, try to sleep, and go back again the next day.
This earthquake has touched every single individual in this town, one way or another.
After you've seen what can happen to a house, it's or to a building, to your office, yeah. The photo of another earthquake is always with you. So as soon as you enter in a building, you know which one is the exit, which one is the nearest exit, where to duck, or what is the place where you would go if an earthquake strikes.
La vie des gens qui travaillent à la MINUSTAH, les étrangers qui travaillent à la MINUSTAH, c'est ce jour-là a changé leur vie. Et c'est la même chose pour tout le monde. Donc, il n'est pas question d'oublier. On n'oublie pas. Et on doit continuer. Il faut continuer. On peut pas rester. On peut pas rester sans rien faire.
And I cannot bring myself to think that our colleagues are actually dead. I don't really know what the word dead means anymore. To me, they're just not here. It doesn't mean that they're no more. They're just not here.
Still, Haiti is always in my heart, as are all my friends that have been there before the earthquake and after the earthquake. And the solidarity that I had with my friends after the earthquake has been something that I will always bring in my heart, and they will always be with me.
Nous avons auditeur avec nous sur LinkedIn pour participer avec nous. Nous avons dit auditeur nous bonjour.
12 janvier, une période noire, difficile, des pleurs, des morts, des cadavres, tout ça, c'est encore là dans ma tête. Je pense avec le temps, ça va s'apaiser, mais c'est encore difficile pour moi.
C'est une image de douleur, c'est une image de déchéance, c'est une image d'angoisse, de tristesse, d'anxiété. C'est une image de détresse humaine qui me vient à l'esprit.
The dust. And the lack of being able to breathe when the building collapsed, and the instant shock of knowing that many people were not here anymore.
The earthquake was such a terrible experience for all of us, and of course it's still inside me. I think I will never forget.
Ça c'est le petit bouteille pour faire les dosages, c'est un bouchon. Passer ici maintenant chez l'équipe là, ils vont expliquer comment monter.
Moi, je me trouve souvent ces jours-là à recommencer à penser à notre collègue, notre ami qui sont restés là. Et je pense aussi à ma famille, ma femme et mon petit enfant qui à l'époque il avait 5 mois. Il était dans un bâtiment qui est tombé.
Toutes les conséquences, tout ce que je vis actuellement, c'est en lien avec le 12 janvier. Le fait que je n'habite plus chez moi, le fait que toutes mes habitudes aient changé, le fait que je dois m'habituer à un environnement nouveau, tout ça, c'est des conséquences, c'est des résultats du 12 janvier. Et je ne pense pas que ça s'en ira de si tôt. Et je pense peut-être sur une bonne période de ma vie, les reliques du 12 janvier continueront encore de se faire sentir.
So you put your life in a different light and you realize that not all the choices you make will bring you somewhere, because there are other events that can happen to you at any given time.
I do get anxious sometimes when I remember that I'm taking things for granted, because the earthquake happened like that, out of the blue. And I'm still afraid that something is going to happen unexpected.
Avant le 12 janvier, j'étais une Christina qui s'en foutait pas mal de la vie, qui vivait comme bon lui semble, parce que je pensais un jour ou l'autre, même si je ne vis pas, je ne suis pas content maintenant, demain je serai content. Mais juste après le 12 janvier, ce n'est plus le cas. J'essaie de vivre chaque minute, chaque seconde, même si j'ai le droit à les choses qui me font mal, le plus loin possible, et profiter de la vie, parce que le 12 janvier m'a donné une belle claque, une belle leçon, alors c'est bien appris.
Life is very fragile, life is short. You can be here now and the moment after you're gone. So what changed in my life is that I finally realized that you have to do your best now. You have to stop delaying things. You have to work, you have to do your best now. Give all of yourself on what you're doing in this right moment, because the day after, maybe you're gone.